Yes. Thank you. There we go. I
Holy
gotta
bu-
panic. Panic.
Uy, kalma ka
Oh, I know I'm trying.
lang
Like
dyan.
it
Ay,
was funny.
calm down. Calm down. You got this.
I know. It's just I haven't. Kim, is Vince online? I don't think he is, but is he? I've heard everything. I literally
Largest
bought a.
one.
I literally bought a dice for this. I actually went to the store, bought a literal dice. You can actually show me. Hello. Hold on. Okay. Please. I will give you a few seconds.
I think this is logic
Hey.
about something that I posted.
What posted?
About
Already?
what I just post.
Oh, that one in the memes?
Yeah. Everyone, behold,
Yeah, I
feast
saw.
your eyes upon the very first servant of the ruler class to actually use a ruler. Well, yeah, I think it
Yeah.
is.
I don't know. I'm just all I gotta say is just fireball. I mean, come on, man. Fireball. Okay.
Hello, everyone.
Hey, yo.
How's everyone doing?
It's going. I think everyone's doing great. I'm doing panicky. I think everyone is.
Are you
I'm
panicking? I'm almost finished. I'm
not.
almost finished with my despair.
I'm freaking out. I don't know why.
Why? No,
It's
don't freak out.
just be calm, man.
No reason to freak
out
out.
since like. No, No, yeah, I know. Like, I was looking for, like, I was like getting scared because about the backup thing. I figured that the others would join, so I was rushing for backup, and then I didn't even plan this ahead. So I'm like, you know what? Whatever. Let's do what we have.
It's okay, we're just gonna talk about horribly terrible things that we're gonna do. Or at least I will. I don't know about everyone else, but I will in fact do
No,
that.
Galaxy, she's already up. She's been screaming.
She's
She's
been
excited for it.
sharpening her knives, loading her guns up.
Okay, so this is authority. Okay. Kim, is there no more chance that Vince will be able to join? Is he even online right now?
I texted both of them, and guess what? They didn't even reply, nor
And there we
even
go.
seen it.
I predicted everything. All right. Okay, since we're already ready. All right. Gotta chill out for a bit. Okay, so this is chaos mode. So I believe this was supposed to be like a sort of finale thing, but since everyone went flip the views, so I guess flip the views. We're doing it early. All
Well,
right. And I put twice the effort now because there instead of like one area, I had like VA suits, so which is why I was already scared that this might fail. But
wow.
You all should be
but
right there.
yeah, what happened?
My mom just called me and she want me to do something. I'll be right back.
All right. Yeah, that's her. All right.
Are
What
we
is
gonna
this? What do I
continue
do?
on, or are we gonna wait?
Okay, maybe let's give him like a few minutes. And while we're at
Right.
it, maybe if there's anyone else,
Vince will not be here. He's on the road.
Great. Great.
So.
I figured. All right. All right.
What did everyone do today?
Panicking.
There's no need to panic.
Just calm down, man.
We're not gonna bite you. We might bite someone else.
I know. I get it.
We're not gonna bite anyone. But we're going to produce some chaos.
Yes. Well, other than panicking, I guess we've been. What have we been doing this week? I've been doing. What is this called? D&D and stuff. What else? Working
That's
on.
Cool.
I've been watching TikTok. Doing TikTok skits. I don't know. That's all I've been doing. And panicking.
So RC.
Yeah.
So I might have a cool thing. So you know the Diary of Callio, the thing I've been working on?
Yeah.
So it is quite possible that the next part of that will have a storyboard animation with it.
Wait, who's gonna do it though?
Paint.
Yes, but this is pretty much.
She said that she would do it, and if we can get it all together, then I'll probably have at least an animation to go along with it. I'm really excited about that.
Yeah, that's cool. That's cool. Okay. I haven't been thinking about, like, my series in general. I've been working on other things, but I've been, like, having some thoughts recently. Series, maybe she might just be free, because I've been thinking about this. I'm closing into like season one, because there's like 8 episodes in season one, and I'm almost close to finishing it, but I've been thinking if I should continue on with season two or just leave it as a script read or whatever, because I don't know if I could. I have like other projects to work on. I've been really scared about talking about it. I'll probably leave it to aside. Not exactly sure yet. Second. Oh, yes. Hilly, what happened? Nothing much. Wait. Bedtime. Hold on. I gotta start the event. I forgot to start event. Thank you. There we go. I forgot. Okay, there we go. Wakey. All right. Beautiful. Ready?
Oh, wait. RC, I want to see how smart you are.
No, what's this about?
All right, hold on. Let me get this picture. I want you to tell me if you understand this joke.
I think I know what this is.
You might. I want to see if other people understand it also.
Okay.
Does anyone understand this besides RC? Because I think you've already seen it.
I've seen it, and all I know is, all I'm thinking is the house, a werewolf. That's all I'm thinking right now.
it turns into a warehouse.
Oh my god.
It took me an embarrassingly long time to figure it out. I was like, is this just like some futuristic galaxy brain meme, or am I just too stupid?
I was thinking maybe the house was like being painted in white when I first saw it. I was like, oh no, is that moon? Had the moon fallen into the house? I don't know.
No, it turned into a warehouse.
Oh, great. Okay, that's so funny. Anyway, I think Galaxy is still there. Oh god.
Galaxy is still there. To find a way to eat a human.
What do you mean, find a way? Vince was just not chill with the cannibals!
Yeah, I just said, would like you to honor my legacy and find a way to eat a human.
Jokes on you, there are no humans.
No, this is chaos mode, right? But I wrote it in such a way that you'll be so attached to characters that you kill them because killing them cry.
How would you feel if we just played this like the safest thing possible and
complete logic? Because I have to sit in her in his place and find a way to eat a bloody human.
I mean,
do you like human on the bone or off the bone? Boneless human.
I mean, Vince, you're actually lucky, Kim, that Vince is in here because usually he's the one going to be eating you. You're going to be used as target.
Well, too bad I'm now the one who eats.
Boneless.
You really got me into it. I'm like, what? Okay. Alright. So, since everyone is here, if Galaxy will be able to make it, I guess we'll just have to start then. Galaxy, you just catch up. Okay. Alright. So, before I do anything, I just want to say credits to all the VAs who helped on this. Wonderful, wonderful job. And it's beautiful. It's beautiful. And you want. I should. All right. Okay. Hopefully this works. And set it up. Okay. Hope it's recording. Yes. All right. Everyone, I hope you have your ears peeled. Because I'm going to start right about. Yes, I should start. You're right, fine. Galaxy, you can just catch up. We'll just catch up and later. I'm just going to click now. Click down the send button, all right? Boom.
A tale of two fathers, both with a strong bond with a child who can read into the thoughts of others without misunderstanding. You sure you want me to read this story?
Yes, I want to hear it.
All right. Once upon a time, in the kingdom of Orthos Imperium, a butler by the name of Edmund just lost his job. The castle he was working at was big, and he would usually find himself getting lost in the midst of the flowery gardens. So naturally, he was heading home after his last paycheck. He got lost, but then he found this little boy, crying.
Oh, goodness gracious me! Thank heavens I found you! It's all right. What are you doing here?
I don't want to go home. My mother, she hates me. She wants me to hide from the world. My father's been long gone since the day of the war.
The butler, having just lost his job and is willing to serve a new employer, approaches the child and helps him up.
You must be the child of one of the higher-ups. It's all right. I will help you find a new home. But first, we must find a way out of the palace.
What should the butler and the child do to get out of the palace? Ask the royal guard for directions? Keep walking forward until you get out? Climb the walls of the castle.
Alright. Got a good start here.
I'm just gonna say, I absolutely adore whoever's doing the voice of the butler.
Yeah, I love it. I love it!
Damn, man.
Right. They're single, right? They're single. I mean, anyhow, so the choices were to find a guard, go through the wall, or just walk.
Just walk forward. Or just walk anywhere until you get out. Not necessarily forward, but if you find some right direction, that's the only way you go.
Okay. We're allowed to ask questions.
Yeah.
Does the wall have like fence posting, like spikes atop of them?
No, but they have turrets because it's a castle. They don't really have spikes.
You know, with a voice like that, I 100% believe that he could probably charm his way with one of the guards, at least. So I'm going to go with guard.
All right. Okay, Kim, you got an answer?
Honestly.
Was that started already?
Yeah, but okay, I'm just going to catch you up easily. So there's a guy, the butler, and then he's like lost his job. He finds a child, and because the entire castle is a maze. So now you have to fight. Now it's either you ask the royal guard, keep walking forward, or just climb the wall to the castle.
On my way. I find my way.
Like, keep walking forward?
Yep.
Okay. Kelsey? I can do a replay.
Vince gave his choice.
What do you mean Vince gave his choice?
It's noble to eat a human. It's a noble cause to recycle.
What the hell?
I just want to point out, this is way back then. Recycling was not a thing yet. So we might be coming with a problem with that part.
And then he gave two thumbs up.
Amazing.
Amazing, Robin. Galaxy.
Would you choose Galaxy?
I think it's gonna be
hard. Oh no, Kim ate her.
Oh no.
Kim's he's chomping down on the competition, if you know what I mean.
Oh no. Okay.
I'm sorry, I'll leave.
No, that's fine. Okay. Galaxy, you there? Hello? Okay. It's probably doing something. Anyway, so
wait. Galaxy?
You said something?
She did.
I'll go with what Kim said. Bye, I agree with it.
Oh.
Walking out.
All right. So, okay. So that's your answer anyway. All right. Okay, so that's Kim. Okay, let me recite. Kim, Galaxy, walk forward, climb the walls of the castle. Okay, in technicality, both keep walking forward and climb the walls of the castle are correct. It was originally just going to be keep walking. I had wrote some thoughts. If you ask the royal guard, you're lost, so finding a guard is going to be a challenge in and of itself. You're lost. Butler originally was lost. And then number two, even if you do manage to find one child you barely know, so the guy arrests you for kidnapping.
Yeah, that's fair enough. But with a voice like that, come on, you should be able to convince anyone.
But it's even worse because you were the child. And then,
okay, yeah, I didn't think about that.
Yeah, and then climb the walls to the castle. I like the original flaw with this, you're with a child and realistically you can climb and carry a child at the same time, but I was thinking if you find some rope you're probably gonna be able to strap the child in your back like a backpack and then just climb up the wall like who are you? One of those hunters in the movies. So yeah, realistically it's gonna be keep walking forward until you get out. So Kim, Galaxy. Well done. All right. We are off to the next part. Give me a second. Hold on. What's the next part? I have to search YouTube. Part two. Okay. Here we go. Here we go. And play. Boom. Perfect.
The butler and the child kept walking forward until they found the gate. They then walk all the way to the butler's hometown. Edmund, knowing that he's going to be taking care of the child until he finds a good home for him, picks up all the parenting books from the local library and practiced every single technique in the book The child, however, unknown to the butler, has telekinetic powers. The child can read minds. One day, the child walked around the village and spotted a familiar face. It was the child's friend, whose father is the general. What should the child do in this situation? Say hello to his friend and play for a while? Read the general's mind and see if he can get any info about his father. Follow them all the way to the palace.
All right. There we go. That's part two. Okay.
Ah.
Okay, guys.
So we're throwing in the part that they're telekinetic now.
Yeah.
So, I mean, if I got the powers, I want to use it. I want to read the general's mind.
All right. I mean, that's
wanna
true.
Be cool. I want to be real cool.
I want to be the cool kid. What's my powers?
Cool kid, Mom. I just want to be the cool kid.
I don't want to be read
minds.
I sent the decisions to Vincent, and then yeah, his first decision about earlier is talk with the guards. If the conversation ain't meaningful, you should eat them.
For crying out loud!
You're assuming that this kid has the capability to defeat essentially fully grown adults and consume them.
Well,
he's telekinetic, not Superman.
I mean, he could be both. Who knows? Alright.
Oh.
So that's it. So you're sending him the links I've been sending?
The decisions only.
Oh. Okay. Alright. So Galaxy, you got...
My decision right now is to ask info.
Ask info. Okay, let me see if I have that. No, I don't actually have that. It's either say hello to friends and play for a while, read the mind of the general, or follow them back to the palace.
Oh, guess I'm just gonna read it. Read the general's mind.
Yeah, be the cool kid! Alright, Galaxy, you got an answer, Haley. If you heard that.
Bloody.
Mind. Nothing. I'd read the general's mind so I can know either he wants violence or peace.
That is a true thing. Haley, if you're hearing this, you just answer the chat box. So before we go into like the actual answer for this, can we just like talk about the option read the general's mind for a second? Like anything could be in his mind. So it's either gonna be a horrifying thing or something useful, or it's probably going to creep out the general and or the kid. Depending on what he's thinking right now.
Okay, wait. How does a general know that he's getting his mind read by this child? Do they have to, like, make eye contact or something?
I don't... Okay. So what I'm thinking, there's, like this child would have to, like, put, like, a certain person, so you have to... the person. So this general... is like once if he's gonna like turn a glance, this child just watching him from afar.
I mean, he's a person of high power. I mean, like kids look up to those kind of people, so he's just like staring in awe, you know.
I mean, that's true, but okay. Going back to like looking at into the mind, if anything could be in his mind right now, like I've been having this thought lately. What could be in the general's mind could be one.
keeping my mouse over the leaf button in case it's a Rickroll.
Yeah. Alright. So, the right answer. Alright, the right answer, yes, you're all correct. The general's obviously. Telekinetic.
Vince said that... Vince said he's gonna read the general's mind. If it's meaningless, he eats the general and become the general.
I eat the general to become the general.
I eat the general.
Is this like how the hierarchy works? To whom is consumed is the one that they become.
Vince has watched too much Attack on Titan, Kim. Do you agree with me?
Vince knows the art of war.
Yeah, just eat men so you can earn their power. Eat the Founding Titan. Founding Titan.
Makes perfect sense.
Makes very perfect sense.
This is just an Argario server. You just eat them, you become bigger.
Just be a higher up. Eat and then higher up. Do people eat kings and then become kings? I get.
Why does remind me of reincarnated as a flying?
Man, the French Revolution was a lot more different than I remember it being.
Oh my god! You had to bring that up.
And she said, "Let them eat cake." I didn't know that's what they meant.
Oh god. Okay, this is part 3. Are we sure? Yes. Okay, but part 3 also. Oh yes, that's part 3.
My father is not dead. I knew it.
The young boy found out through the general that his father, who was once the prince, now king of Orthos Imperium, is coming back home. However, the king returns because he found out his son ran away. The general is now in search of the young prince.
Sir Edmund, my father, he wants to take me back to the palace.
Well, that's good. You can finally be the... Wait, are you the missing prince everyone's been looking for?
Unfortunately, my mother, as well as my father, want me back and hidden in the palace. And here I thought my dad was a good man.
What should the butler do? Take the boy to another land where he can be free? Change his appearance and keep living hidden amongst the shadows? Send him.
Okay, I love how I'm just throwing you right plot twists.
I feel like I need to address my opinion on it. First off, I was the butler in this situation, I'd be asking why this kid is so adamant about not going home first.
True, that is... I mean, didn't...
I would like to know what these parents are doing to this child to make him run away, so...
Alright, so here's the thing. Alright, maybe I should just... Because it is part of part 4, but to explain, number one, he does have telekinetic powers, and that can be dangerous at times, especially with war planning, reading attacks and other stuff. That could be dangerous, so they're trying to keep him away so they have, you know, he doesn't get killed and whatever. No. Number two, he is a prince, so, and prince are kind of a prince with powers, especially, so he has to be locked inside, but this child wants to see the real world. He wants to, like, explore and stuff, and he's like a very adventurous kid. His parents would let him. I kind of took inspiration from Korea and Rama, actually. He wants to show his face, because the public also hasn't seen his face, which is why, like, what are the options? Say hello to his friend, like, the friend doesn't recognize him, because he isn't really being shown to the public, so that's what I was thinking, writing the child.
Okay.
I choose to take the boy to another land.
All right.
Sure, yeah. I mean, if he's really adamant about it, I might as well do the same.
If he wants to see the world, see the world.
I can show you the world.
I can show
you. I haven't seen that movie in years. The last time I watched it was on VHS. That's how old it was.
You're old?
I'm old. I pay taxes.
I pay taxes.
Damn. I didn't even pay taxes.
Yes.
Bro, we're like younger than this dude.
I think I'm the oldest one here.
Of course you are the oldest one here. You're literally the only few adults in here.
Yeah.
He's the father.
You'll get there eventually, don't worry.
I don't
know. Nah.
But Kim anyhow, yes. I will heed to this boy's request and take him to whatever land he so desires.
And I'm gonna be his father.
Honestly, with a voice like that, yeah. I'd be the perfect dad.
I mean, you're not even a dad at this point.
You need to introduce me to this person. I'm gonna need him for something.
Yeah, alright, hold on. Where is he? Discord thing.
I'm actually gonna Discord him right now.
Yeah, hold on.
I was just saying, if you ever want to collab on something, I could really use someone with that kind of voice.
There we go. This beautiful, beautiful voice. He actually got a lot of followers on YouTube. Really interesting. A shock. It was such a shock.
Oh my god.
Galaxy, yeah. You got an answer?
I got an answer.
Yeah.
Let's hear it.
I would rather hide the freaking child.
Bro, what the fuck?
And put him in a fucking prison. I'ma put him in his snug-nosed mouth.
Yelsey, is that your sister going, what the heck?
Yeah. My sister is right beside me. Excuse her.
Hello, Sora Galaxy sister.
Hi. Hello, I told her I said hi. I haven't seen her in a while.
Yeah. You haven't seen her in a while, right, RC?
Yeah, I haven't.
Say hi.
Oh no.
Oh, hi! Buhay ka pa pala! You mean? Of course she's alive!
I'm not dead, thank you very much. Alright.
Forget his eyes, drop me. So yeah, that's
the Someone's got it.
Someone's cutting. Who's cutting? All right. So the answer. Yeah. So Nico Kim like lead to another land galaxy, change his appearance, and like hide the child. All right. So the answer. Okay. Kim and Nico are right again. Take the boy to another land where he could be free. Because if you keep the guy, okay, keep the child in the city, he's like there's a very big possibility that he can still be found. Since the king is going to return and they're going to have a search party. And then, obviously, to bring the boy to the father, that's just betrayal at this point. So, yeah. That's pretty much the antics. Hold on. Part 4? Am I cutting? Can you still hear me? Oh, I thought it was... Okay, this is where the interesting part happens. I spent the money on. I literally spent money on a dice. I bought a dice at the store. Like, not even just a dice. I bought 6 of them.
A d20? Or just like a
no.
d6?
A normal dice. I don't think that exists. I don't know if that even exists in our place.
A d20? You know what? Probably not. Yeah.
Probably just. It's not really that. I don't really think that it exists. Maybe. Okay, this is where this gets interesting. I want you to pay attention to this one because the ending will depend on you.
The butler bid the little child goodbye when suddenly the king and his men caught up to them. The butler seemed frightened. The little boy read the butler's mind and realized he was his father's old butler.
Sir Edmund, did you lead me to them?
What? No! I would never-
I was born a telepath!
But what now?
You were the king's loyal butler! You didn't lose your job! They sent you to look for me!
Okay, true. I was sent to find you, but hear me out! I didn't want you trapped inside the palace. I found it unfair. So I decided to sneak you out. I didn't think it would lead to this.
The young boy then looked at his father.
My son, you can't go with him. Your powers are too dangerous. Come with me. As for you, butler, you are no longer useful.
The kid now has to choose. Does he give in to his hatred and side with the king, forever living in despair? Or go with the butler, but in turn risking both of their lives?
All right. That is final. This is it.
All right. So
that was some bloody beautiful voice acting, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Excuse me if what I'm gonna say gonna really blow your mind or either panic.
Are you saying that figuratively or literally?
Expect anything good from me. I would choose to kill the king right there and just run. If there's no king, then no one's gonna run after them. Like, there will be no evidence. You just have to burn them alive.
So you think, wait, okay, this is where the chaos comes.
But hear me out, hear me out. Why I choose that? We all know that the child has hatred from his parents and trusted his butler.
Yeah.
Since he doesn't want to go back, then he wants to go to the butler and just roam around in the world. Really? He should really kill the king right there, even with his guards. Kill them, burn them alive, sacrifice them.
I keep the boy and eat the king, so that I become the king.
So currently, it's kill the king and destroy everything. So that's.
Mom.
Can you even write an indie for? Can they go?
You.
Just kidding.
What?
I would just keep the boy.
You guys are chopping. Nico? Okay, Nico.
Okay. So, I'm this boy, and this, my father, has just told me that my powers are dangerous. Meaning, I have full, that gives me the incentive that I have full capability of to kill a man. That's what I'm getting from this.
I mean, is not an option, but I mean, I guess.
I'm just gonna explode his mind. I'm just gonna blow his mind, quite literally. Like a melon.
Literally?
Like a melon.
Bro!
Literally.
Kill the king. Kill it.
This is where the chaos comes.
So Vin said about these two decisions from earlier until now, Vin said eat the boy.
This is my response. This is my response. This is to do this.
If Vin said eat the boy, I said eat the king and become the king.
Consume king.
Oh, God.
If we want to take this a non-murdery approach, I'll just use telepathy to remove the king's crown, put it on my head, boom, now I'm king. We're playing checkers up in here now.
Yep.
Oh, my. So
you have been dethroned.
Telepathy doesn't work like that.
Okay, so you said telepathy, which is controlling things with your mind. Telepathy is like controlling thought, like being able to communicate through thought. But because you said telepathy, that's doing it like using your mind to move stuff and junk, which does entail like pyrokinesis and stuff like that. So yes, you could burn people, just to let you know, Galaxy. And Kim, I don't know what's up with you. You're just a cannibal.
That's the first thing that crossed my mind after I said keep the boy.
No, you saw the king and you were just like, Burger King.
Yummy! Steak!
Oh my.
Time for my Whopper.
Time.
There's not a part of this that doesn't end in some form of death.
And Vince
it's chaos! Vince, I was actually surprised, like...
Vince always chooses eat, and eat. Eat the guards, eat the general, eat the bloody boy.
I'm convinced that you guys are... Yeah, I'm convinced that you guys are a descendant of dinosaurs. I'm not talking like the plant-eating dinosaurs. No, I'm talking about velociraptors. Everything that eats. I'm 100% convinced.
But for some reason, why am I being satisfying with this watermelon being exploding again and again?
It's beautiful, isn't it?
Like fireworks.
But what if it was a broken and you explode it like that?
Satisfaction 100.
Bro.
Bloody hell, man.
Chaos.
This is exactly what I expected from Chaos Mode. This is exactly.
Yep. In terms of this, every day is Halloween.
Why is this? Yeah, I was wondering why is everyone starting to be logic and then them kill the king. There we go. Okay. The choices are gonna like. Okay, so. Yeah, I did not, right?
Yo, sis, hold on. I got a question. Hmm? Would you either save the child or kill the king?
Save the child.
Child's
way longer life. God, I don't know really. Okay, this is just one of you guys have really defeated me. I did not write an ending for this. I had all the possibilities. I even wrote an ending 7 just in case it weren't going to plan. But you ended up saying kill the king, blow him up, and oh no.
First rule.
Oh no.
You should know about D&D and stuff. You'll never be prepared for people's chaos.
How does Dungeon Master survive this exactly?
You know what? Literally, okay, so like let me give you the rundown of what happened in our last session. So essentially, we started off with our friends mass poisoning an entire city. I dealt with the bodies that were in the city, while my friends went and go play Charlie's Angels in a cavern. How the heck are you supposed to prepare for that? It's just a whole roller coaster tycoon of everything bad and good happening.
Well, everything happened.
BM's like, what on earth is this? What's the next step? Do I have them all killed?
You literally have to be great at improving to be a DM.
I'm proud of you. Choose to kill the king.
Every decision is mine.
Y'all just defeated me on this one. Oh god.
This RC.
I had like an ending 7, and then like I had because there were 6 sides of the dice. Like I had an ending 7 where what do you call this? Just in case you decide to kill the butler and then the king. I had that, and then I just said like kill the king. Did you specifically also want to kill the butler, or you just want the king? Did I do it? I think I have an ending for that. But not the killing, literally. But, like, I have an ending for that.
If you don't have an ending where the king is killed, you better make one. Do it. I chose that ending.
Can't come up with this. I can't do this on the spot. Okay. So if you're siding with the bug, killing the. All right. So let's. So the guy, the kid, kills the king. All right. So that's where we're gonna start off with, and then what could possibly happen? The butler looks at the child, very concerned, very concerned away. And then, what else could he add? The butler's like, well, why are you doing, what's this? And then, like, the child looks at the butler, creepily, and laughs maniacally. And then drops out of the forest, never to be seen again. The
She really just went
with Yay.
And then this is Galaxy's. This is Galaxy's way.
Go nuts.
Very interesting, yeah.
It's how we do it.
We kill and we eat people. Does this consider a bloody dark humor?
It's his fault, okay? Not mine. I'm just what does she want? She wants chaos. Chaos.
Hey, I didn't. Chaos. I mean, I was like wondering why you were wondering. What are you? Are you okay? Well, you really took me aback right there. I didn't have an improv script ready. But all right. But you just imagine like the butler, the child just. Exploding and then just, you know, trotting out. Trotting down the forest. The butler's like, oh, help. Maybe everyone's really scared. Alright, yeah, guys, I think you guys have successfully defeated me. Well done.
Naturally.
We defeated the author.
Trials without it.
Defeated the dungeon master.
The character defeated the author.
I defeated. 1.4 point for her.
I mean, you've got to defeat me a lot of times. All right, I guess that is the end of the flipping session. I'm just gonna call things sessions now.
Now it's time for my victory theme.
Oh no. I'm not even saying this. Come on, Lilith.
Yeah, you rickroll, Dorsey.
You guys planned this?
No, I anticipated it. I just anticipated it.
Well,
you defeated Archie. Well, let's go.
It's fun.
Well, wait. Hold on.
No, I won't let you get a rebuttal on this. I'm not even typing yet.
If I would.
I literally have my thing hovered over the leave button.
All right. Okay.
I'm gonna make the sauce. I'm hungry after that. Damn.